Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Nada Osama Fouad, ID 184707. I'm a TEFLR student, fourth year, on the Faculty of Languages and Translation. I'm so happy to teach to you today, and I wish that you would find today's topic beneficial for you all. Okay, let's start. Okay, let's guess the topic of today. We will just watch a short video for 24 seconds. Please try to understand the message of the video and to guess today's topic. Did you understand? Shall I play it again? Play it again?
Yes.
Okay. You enjoyed? Okay. Can someone tell me what's the message of today's topic? What's the message? What's the message? Okay.
The difference between leader and manager.
What?
The difference between leader and manager.
The difference between a leader and a manager. Okay, you?
The leader is not mean to be following someone. The leader must be help each other.
Okay. Okay. Can you please describe what you just saw? Describe. Just describe.
You see that the leader don't want to...
It's a dog, not a leader. It's a dog.
We see that the dog...
What?
Wasn't need to help his...
Didn't want to help the friends, okay, or the team. Yes.
And they left them want to drink.
Okay, so the other dog just solved the problem.
Yeah.
So he solved just the problem. Okay, so I believe that you just guessed today's topic. Today's topic is about leadership and mainly focusing on the difference between a leader and a manager. Okay. What comes to your mind when you hear the word leadership? Or let's specify it, a leader. What comes to your mind? Wait. Let's bat through the balls.
Ms. Muskelos,
what comes to your mind when you hear the word leader?
The person who tells me what to do or his tasks.
Leader?
Who tells the task or what to do?
Okay, throw the ball to another person. You choose. Come on, what comes to your mind when you hear the word leadership? I'm waiting. Leadership. Example of leadership or leader. You don't? Okay, throw the ball. Come on. Come on.
Someone who solves any problem.
Okay, maybe. Throw it. Choose. Come on. Okay, I would help you. These are visuals to help you here. Come on, use the visuals. Okay, describe to me what's the difference between a leader and a boss. Just describe the picture.
ثرو جامد. Come on, describe this picture.
The boss give the orders to the those members. Either can help him.
The boss only gives orders, right? This is very right. He's sitting, as we can see, he's sitting on his chair and he's ordering the team to pull him up or to go to the objective or to make the achievement. However, the leader is the one who is leading the group. And that's the difference. I'm just not telling you, like, do the task. No, I'm helping you and supporting you with doing the task. Because we have a mutual objective and we have a mutual achievement. That's the main difference, okay? Okay, we will now do task one. This is task one. This vocabulary you will find just a little bit difficult, and this you will match the word with its right definition. If you didn't find the task, this is according to Turkan. This is task one. Do you have this paper? If you don't have this paper, it's here. Just fill out, okay? So what we're gonna do, we will match the word with its right definition. I will help you with the first one. Leadership. What do you believe the answer? Right, the action of leading a group of people or an organization. This is the definition of the word leadership, okay? The words are leadership, management, mindset, persuasion, status, co, mentor, and sophisticated. Okay, you have 3 minutes. Just make it individually. Three minutes. Match the word with its right definition. Like number one is G. You have fun? You have a problem? These are all the tasks. You're lucky. Okay, I will distribute them. Okay? Have a paper? If you don't have a paper, fill it out. Okay? If you don't have a paper, just have a paper in your own and fill it out. This is the task. This is a different one. Have a paper and fill it out. Okay. Have you finished? Okay. Why are you not participating? What? Fill it out. Ay, what are you? Oh. Fine. You have a difficult. You have a problem? Oh, good. No. One minute. You have a problem? No problem.
have a problem? Why not filling out? Fill it out. Okay, let's discuss the answers. Where's the ball? Where's the ball? لا 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 عبد الله لا اي ورقه 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 سهريك ورقه النهارده بقى throw it بقى you throw it come on we answered number one leadership and we said that it's G the action of leading a group of people or an organization management F the process of dealing with or controlling things or people. Remember the word of controlling and the word of leading through the board. Come on. Mindset. Mindset E, an experienced or trusted advisor. What do you think? Do you believe it's true? What's the right? What? B, the established set of attitudes held by someone. Okay, mindset. Okay, persuasion. Okay. What? Persuasion? E?
D.
D, the action of or process of persuading someone or of being persuaded. Do or believe something right. Status quo. Come on.
C.
C. The existing state of affairs, especially regarding social or political issues. Excellent. Mentor. Throw the ball, throw the ball.
A.
A. Machine system, what do you think? E, an experienced or trusted advisor. Excellent. The last one, sophisticated. A, machine, system, or technique developed to a high degree of complexity. Excellent. Thank you. This is the right order. 1G, 2F, 3B, 4D, 5C, 6E, and 7A. Now let's explain the answers. Leadership. Leadership is a noun. As we said before, it's the action of leading a group of people or an organization as the state or position of being a leader. Okay. Management, it's also a noun. Management is the coordination of all resources through the process of planning, organizing, directing, and controlling in order to attain stated goals. It's the process also of dealing with or controlling things or people. Remember these words. Mindset, it's also a noun. The established set of attitudes held by someone. A mindset refers to whether you believe qualities such as intelligence and talent are fixed or changeable traits. You know the difference between a person who had a fixed mindset or a growth mindset? Who could tell me the difference? A person with a fixed and growth mindset. Fixed and growth mindset. Come on. Fixed. Okay. It's what? No.
Still
fixed mindset. And a growth mindset. Okay, you're so close. Fixed mindset, a person with a stabilized beliefs. He does not want to change his beliefs. He has a fixed mindset, okay? Like one who's sticking with the stereotypes. This is a fixed mindset. However, the growth mindset, a person who is totally flexible, communicating, changing the beliefs, discovering, he has a growth mindset, okay? Okay. Persuasion, it's also a noun. Persuasion is defined as the act of trying to convince someone of something or the means of convincing someone to do something. When someone lists all the reasons why you should do something, this is an example of persuasion. Like you are convincing, what's your name?
Iyad.
You are convincing Iyad to go out of this lecture and to go to Idra. Or to buy anything from the food court. You are listing your reasons. This is a boring class. What's going on here? I just want to go out. You are persuading, you are listing your reasons why you should go out of this lecture. This is a kind of persuasion, okay? Status quo is also a noun. The existing state of affairs, especially regarding social or political issues. It's the state of things, the way things are, as opposed to the way they could be. The existing state of affairs. It's the existing state of social or political issues. Existing state, okay? Mentor. Do you know the mentor on Facebook? That's my mentor on Facebook. Mentor is a person who shares information, who gives information or advices for your career path, as well as provide guidance, motivation, emotional support, and role modeling. He's also just like, this is my mentor. I used to ask him for advice, and he used to just give me the right path, give me advices. He's more experienced than me, and he's giving me advices. Okay, that's the meaning of a mentor, like a mentor on Facebook. Sophisticated. This is the only adjective word. Sophisticated is a machine, system, or technique. We will highlight the word technique. Developed to a high degree of complexity. Something very, very, very complex, okay? And it's an adjective. As we can see that most of the words, actually all of them except sophisticated, are nouns. Noun is a word used to identify any of a class of people, places, or things. However, an adjective is describing the referent. Like maybe you are very beautiful. Beautiful is an adjective. I'm describing you as to be beautiful. Okay? Okay. Now you're going to watch a video for 3 minutes for the first time. While watching, please concentrate on the main ideas. You will find the accent is British accent and he's talking a little bit fast. But you will find some subtitles, but not here, there on the top with the highlighted important words. Just listen for the first time for the main ideas, okay?
Over the past couple of decades, a recurring question that I hear from people is, what are the differences between managers and leaders? And I don't believe there's a really hard and fast line that completely distinguishes the two, but I do feel that the data, the results, give us an interesting place to jump off of to take a look at ourselves. So let's dig deeper into this. Hello friends, I'm Alex Lyon and this is Communication Coach. I'm here to help you increase your impact and lead your teams to higher levels of excellence. And today's topic is the difference and similarities between managers and leaders. And I've been asked this question a lot, and what I did was I looked at various sources online, and I've done a lot of reading over the years on my own, in addition to a book I wrote on leadership. And what I did is I came up with a little comparison of all the things that are out there, looking at different categories, and I boiled it down to some basic categories that show what I feel are pretty clear differences between managers and leaders. And we'll talk about that in just a moment, but the first point I want to make is clear. In most of the readings that you'll see, and most of the people that you talk to, they will tell you that there's no such thing as 100% manager and 100% leader, because we all have to do a little bit of the other. The other thing they'll tell you is that managers are clearly in a managerial position, whereas leaders can lead from anywhere. You can actually be in just an individual contributor role. You don't have a managerial position of any kind, but you can lead by example, and you can put a lot of influence into your team and actually push them forward in a way that maybe even the official manager of that team is not doing. So you can lead from any position. It's a little bit like that movie Ratatouille. A leader can come from anywhere, where the manager is usually tied to the official position. So let's now dig down into some of the results here and take a look at what the overall categories were that I distilled from everything I read. And by the way, I'm going to put links to all those things in this description below so you can dig deeper into those sources if you would like to. So let's look at managers first. First of all, managers have a more of a control mindset. They're focused on the administration of processes and the structure and the resources of the organization. They're very much into maintaining the status quo, so maintenance is a key part of what they do, and they're very task-focused. So overall, managers are working on the day-to-day tasks and making sure that everything gets done in an orderly fashion. Leaders, however, are a little bit different. Leaders have a more persuasive approach to communication rather than controlling. Leaders are focused on taking the organization from here to there. That's a name of a video series by Bill Hybels, a great leadership author. He talks about going from A to B. A leader is different from anybody else because they want to take people from here to there. In basic form, that's one of the main ways he sees leadership. Leaders also are known for taking risks. Instead of maintaining the status quo, keeping things steady, they are trying to stretch the organization past what it's currently doing, and that involves taking risks. Leaders are also much more people-focused and relationship-focused. They do more mentoring, more coaching, more teaching.
Okay. Did you understand the difference or the different qualities between a leader and a manager? Okay. Now we will make task two. Before listening, I will read it with you. Here is task two. You will find it here. It's right, wrong, and correct the wrong answer. Just stick right or wrong beside the sentence and correct the wrong answer. The person should be either 100% leader or 100% manager. Managerial positions are for leaders. If you're a leader, you can lead from anywhere. You cannot lead by example. Managers have control mindset and try to maintain the status quo. Managers are not task-oriented. Managers work on daily tasks. Leaders control rather than communicate. Managers are risk takers. Leaders tend to stretch the organization. This is the task, okay? Okay, be careful and I will play the audio again. And gradually with the presenter, you will just stick the right answer and correct the wrong one, okay? Clear, do you have any questions? Okay.
Over the past couple of decades, a recurring question that I hear from people is, what are the differences between managers and leaders? And I don't believe there's a really hard and fast line that completely distinguishes the two, but I do feel that the data, the results, give us an interesting place to jump off of to take a look at ourselves. So let's dig deeper into this. Hello friends, I'm Alex Lyon and this is Communication Coach. I'm here to help you increase your impact and lead your teams to higher levels of excellence. And today's topic is the differences and similarities between managers and leaders. And I've been asked this question a lot, and what I did was I looked at various sources online, and I've done a lot of reading over the years on my own, in addition to a book I wrote on leadership. And what I did is I came up with a little comparison of all the things that are out there, looking at different categories, and I boiled it down to some basic categories that show what I feel are pretty clear differences between managers and leaders. And we'll talk about that in just a moment. But the first point I want to make is clear. In most of the readings that you see, and most of the people that I talk to, they will tell you that there's no such thing as a 100% manager and a 100% leader, because we all have to do a little bit of the other. The other thing I'll tell you is that managers are clearly in a managerial position, whereas leaders can lead from anywhere. You can actually be in just an individual contributor role. You don't have to be
in the Michael Tosk.
But you can lead by example and you can put a lot of influence into your team.
احنا ده حلنا المره اللي فاتت. ده فاضل مايند سيت.
Oh,
بالظبط. مايند سيت.
It's a little bit like that movie Ratatouille. A leader can come from anywhere, where the manager is really tied to the
position.
So let's now down into some of the results here and take a look at what the overall categories were that I distilled from everything I read. And by the way, I'm going to put links to all those things in this description below so you can dig deeper into those sources if you would like to. So let's look at managers first. First of all, managers have a more of a control mindset. They're focused on the administration of processes and the structure and the resources of the organization. They're very much into maintaining the status quo, so maintenance is a key part of what they do. And they're very task-focused. So overall, managers are working on the day-to-day task of making sure that everything gets done in an orderly fashion. Leaders, however, are a little bit different. Leaders have a more persuasive approach to communication rather than controlling. Leaders are focused on taking the organization from here to there. That's a name of a video series by Bill Hybels, a great leadership author. He talks about going from A to B. A leader is different from anybody else because they want to take people from here to there. In basic form, that's one of the main ways he sees leadership. Leaders also are known for taking risks. Instead of maintaining the status quo and keeping things steady, they are trying to stretch the organization past what it's currently doing, and that involves taking risks. Leaders are also much more people-focused and relationship-focused. They do more mentoring, more coaching, more people.
Okay, you can check your answer with your pair. Okay. Where's the boo? Okay. The person should be either 100% leader or 100% manager? Wrong. What's the correct answer?
We have to be 50-50. B, the both, no one.
Should not, yes. Right. Then number one is wrong, and we should not be either 100% leader and 100% manager. We can go through both. Number two, managerial positions are for leaders. False. What's the right? Why? Excellent. Badal. What? Managers. Yes. Okay. Number three. If you are a leader, you can lead from anywhere.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. You cannot lead by example. Raise your voice. Yes or no?
No.
You cannot lead by example. Why? Because we can lead by example. Okay. Managers have control mindset and try to maintain the status quo.
True.
Okay. Managers are not task oriented. False. What's the right? They are, right. They are task oriented. Managers work on daily tasks. Yes. Excellent. Leaders control rather than communicate.
False.
What's the right? Lax. Okay, managers are risk takers?
No,
leaders are risk takers. Leaders tend to stretch the organization?
True.
Excellent, thank you so much. Task three. You like the task three? Okay. Okay. Task three, we will fill out the empathy boxes of manager, leader, by using the given words according to the qualities of each one. These are some words, and we will just pick the word and put it in the right box of a manager or leader. Like, for example, what do you believe we can put in the box of leader?
Risk taker.
Risk taker. And the manager? What? Control mindset. Excellent. Okay, you can do this in groups. You have 5 minutes. You don't have a paper, write it down. خليك جاوبي اول واحده. ال هي اللي لونها فضي. اوكي هجيبها اسود. طيب هشوفها حد.
Empowerment.
بس هي مش موجودة خالص، مش موجودة. طب ما حد، طب هشوفها لك بعد الكلاس، انا قربت خلاص. Everything is good. اخبار المانجرز ايه؟ ليدرز بقى ايه؟
صغير بس هي بيبي بروجرس، مش مفهوم مانجر؟
لا ليدر، عشان هو he's trying to focus on people, he's not trying to focus on just the object. البدل الحلوة قوي يعني. Why you're not participating? She's even not. Why you're not participating?
مفيش جروب.
إيه؟ طب ما تقعدي معايا. شوي.
مش قادرة أقوم.
مش ها مفيش. بصي أنتي. يا سلام برافو. Do you have a problem؟ فين طيب؟ حلو؟
اهو معايا.
تمام. لو تحبي تشوفي الفلاشة، تحبي تشوفي الفلاشة؟ طيب هل هيتخبط؟ ايوه بس حاسي، بس تعملي اي حاجة. 1 مينيت خلصنا. منتين ستاتوس كو؟ منتين الستاتوس كو اللي هو الحاجة الستيبل، دايما بيمشي على الحاجة الستيبل، مش ريسك تيكر، عكس ريسك تيكر. ايه؟ دي هتبقى مانجر. يس يس. Have you finished؟ Have you finished؟ All؟ Okay. Come on. Okay, come on, with a loud voice كده. Risk taker, which one? Risk taker leader, control mindset. Manager, task oriented. Man, إيه؟ Manager. People focused. Who says leader? Leader, raise your hand. Manager? People focused is a leader, not a manager. He's focusing on people. The manager is just focusing on the goal or on the objective. Okay? Okay. Daily task focused. Manager. Relationship focused. Leader. Inspire. Leader. Order. Manager. Persuasion. Leader. Power. Manager. Communicate. Leader. Maintain status quo, manager. Thank you. This is a feedback. Who's the boss? Okay, the manager tends to have a control mindset. He's always task oriented. He's daily focused. He maintains to have ordering. He loves power and he always maintains the status quo. However, the leader is a risk taker. He's a people-focused person. He always focuses on relationship, He always inspire, persuasion, and the most important thing that he always communicate. Okay? We will see why communication is very important now. Group activity. Okay. This is a case study. Okay? Try to solve the case study by using the qualities of a leader and write in a short paragraph your answer. You will be in groups, just 5 or 6 person, okay? You will have to be to fill out this case, solve this case by using the leadership qualities. We saw them, okay? Try to apply them and try to be just in a leading position and write a short paragraph on how you will solve this problem. Okay, what's the case study? You are hired in a leading position in a bank. Your team consists of 5 members: Sara, Noha, Hadi, Omar, and Rami. One time, Noha came to you as the team leader, complaining from Omar, who verbally attacked her in front of the whole team. Okay, as a leader, how can you solve this problem by using leadership skills? How would you react to the problem? How you will talk to Noha, communicate to Noha and Omar? And what decision you will take? You will have 10 minutes filling out the written paragraph with your group. Okay? Please use personal pronouns like I will make, I will solve, I will talk in a short paragraph. Okay? From every group, one representative will go out there and read the paragraph in front of the whole class. Okay? You have 10 minutes. What do you want? You are the leader. هي نهى جاي تشتكي لك انت. Okay, you are the leader. Okay. مش مشكلة بقى، اوكي تمام تمام ايه؟ ما هي قالت لي بس كل ده مروتين يعني دي مش حاجة يعني ما ينفعش مش 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 voice. How would you solve the problem بقى بالنسبة للبدل؟ عايزين البدل تشتغل. يعني team leader بقى عايزين بقى short paragraph كده. How would you solve this problem? By the way, this is the بجد يعني ده بيحصل يعني as a team leader لما حتى لو team عادي حتى student activity you are responsible to solve these kinds of case studies يعني.
طب احنا نحل اول question بس
لا مش اول question ال questions دي to help you writing your short paragraph.
كل team هتطلعوا واحد ولا هو
واحد بس يطلع من كل team. البدل بقى. يا اخبار الدنيا ايه دي helping questions to let you write يعني better ال short paragraph ده as a team leader or the team leader student activity team مشكله حصل حل يعني حل بقى وروني بقى اوكي على فكره انا كنت الهيد فويس يعني how are you ايه الاخبار انت بتخبي ليه يعني writing a short paragraph طبعا طبعا
هو هناك كل واحد بالانجلش بشكل كويس
مثلا I will listen to Noha and Omar each one separately okay are you or individually
مش
الاخبار مش هننام. لا فين السورت باراجراف؟
هم بيكتبوا انا هبريزنت.
والله ماشي. طب فين اللي بيكتب بقى؟ اه اوكي تمام. ده انتوا كل ده جروب؟
اربعه بس.
خلاص تمام اوكي. لا لا برافو 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 جدا النهارده. شكلكم بتحبوا مانجمنت قوي. لا لا ليه حلوه حلو. لا 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 بجد. طب واتس يور فيدباك؟ دو يو لايك ذا سيشن بجد؟ اوكي ثانك يو. انا اي انجويد جدا معاك بالبدله يعني. على حسب بقى يعني هناخد ريبريزنتر من كل جروب. ايه اجازه؟ ايه
اجازه؟
ايه اجازه؟
ابانش حد ابانش عمر.
ورنينج warning one warning. اه I will give him a warning.
طب احنا قلنا في اول واحده ان احنا نتكلم مع كل واحد لوحده.
تمام. تفتكر انت المفروض القرار اللي انت تاخده يبنى على ايه؟
على اللي حصل.
على اللي حصل بس. طب ماشي ادي مشكله حصلت، مش في طرفين في المشكله؟ طرف زعل وطرف سبب المشكله. طب سبب المشكله ده تفتكر مثلا ممكن لو اعتذر، ممكن لو قال ما اقصدش، ممكن لو قال انا طريقتي كده اسف بحاول اعدلها، مش هو هنا بيبقى اتيتيود اكوردنج تو ذا اتيتيود؟ عارف لو حد مثلا اعتذر واتيتيوده وحش والله اعتذاره مش هيتقبل، صح؟ فين الاجزاء؟ فين انت فين؟ مفيش. فبالتالي في اغلب الديسيجنز اللي بيبقى فيها ليدرز لازم الديسيجن بيتاخد اكوردنج تو ذا اتيتيود اوف ذا بيرسون اللي عمل المشكله، مش بقى مش اللي هو ايه لو مانجر فاير يلا ده يعني غيرك هيجي يعني. لكن يعني الليدر بيبقى هيز فيري كين على ان هو يعمل بوندينج مع التيم بتاعه. تمام. بس one minute one minute. have you all finished? 1 minute. 1 minute. Come on. You finished? Oh. يقتنع. Persuasion. I'm convincing you. I'm convincing. Convincing بقنعك. Okay, done. You all finished? لا يس خلاص. Okay. لا 2 minutes. Where is the first representative? Who would like to come? Hmm. Don't let me to choose the first representative. You will just say your paragraph. You will just read your paragraph. طب يلا بقى يلا 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 مفيش حد يلا 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 ما عايزه اتفائل بيكم
ممكن يكون عندك
عادي هنتعلم مفيش مشكله كمان كمان والنبي كمان كمان طب حد فيكم يلا يلا كمان كمان we'd like to listen to اسمك ايه what's your name سيف we'd like to listen to سيف كمان يا سيف okay voice Listen to your colleague. Loud voice, but loud voice.
First, you must to be called. Second, order Omar to apologize.
The way for me.
Apologize to Noha.
Okay.
In front of whole team.
In front of the whole team. Okay,
and,
great.
Give Omar a warning.
You will give Omar a warning. You will let him apologize to Noha in front of the whole team. This is how you will react as a leader. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. Who's else? Come on. Reader about that. Loud voice. Listen, listen, listen. Listen, please, listen, your voice. Come on.
I will solve this problem to communicate with Noha and Omar.
By communicating with Noha and Omar, but okay. Yes.
I know what happened.
Okay.
To do that.
Okay.
And that's it. And the react, I give both the warning.
You will give a warning, okay.
To
Omar, okay.
La, not Omar only.
You will what?
Not Omar only.
Not Omar.
Omar and Noha.
Omar and Noha?
Yes.
You will give Noha a warning?
Yes.
Why? they have a misbehavior.
Yes.
Okay. A point, okay. Come on. No one would complain to you. Come on.
I give him warning and I remove some salary from
Salary كمان?
Omar only.
So you will give warning to Noha and Omar and you will remove a sort of a salary
from Omar.
From Omar.
Yes.
This is how you would react. Okay.
With decision, okay. I discuss with them and if I'm not convinced, I will خايف اقول كيك.
لا كتير قوي. Okay, thank you. Who else? Come on بقى عايزين نسمع حاجة حلوة بقى. يلا. Come on, listen, listen. Listen.
First, I will listen to the whole team.
Okay, great. You will listen to the whole team.
No more about the personality of Omar and Noah.
What?
And no more about the personality of Omar and Noah.
Okay. Okay.
Second, I'll be biased in my decision.
You will be biased?
Biased.
Biased?
Wise.
Wise? You will be wise, okay. Biased is something else, okay. You will be wise with your, with taking your decision. Okay, what else? How?
Okay. Third, I will listen to the Noha and Omar each one separately.
You will listen to Noha and Omar each one separately, okay?
Fourth, I will give the
خاطئ مثلا او
you will talk
لا يعني هدي الغلط المذنب مثلا هدي المذنب ده اسمه ايه بقى
you will give warning to Omar
and then I will punish him.
You will punish ايه
وبعدين حاجه تاني لو حصل تاني يعني اصلا
اوكي لا لا great thank you who else come on all groups are finished please the voice okay have you finished okay let's see the answers come on come on
First, I will try to solve this problem in a secret way without embarrassing both of them.
Okay.
On the other hand, my action will be calm and not aggressive. And
great.
I will warn Omar not to make this problem again.
Okay, thank you so much. Clap your hands for this. Okay. You all did great, but we will now see how an actual leader will solve this problem by using just simple techniques. Firstly, you should listen carefully to Noha and apologize. You're apologizing for a person who is complaining for you. So you just, I'm sorry for you, all that stuff, okay? Secondly, you should go and talk to Omar after the complaint and listen to his answer with using a soft voice tonality and communication. Voice tonality, this is my voice tonality. This is a slow and calm voice tonality. This is a huge and loud voice tonality. Okay? Okay. If he rejected the complaint or refused the complaint, you should go and ask the rest of the team. Why you should go and ask the rest of the team? Because he attacked her verbally in front of the whole team. So you have evidence. You should go and ask the rest of the team if this complaint is true or not. Okay? Okay. After confirming the complaint, you should let Omar apologizing to Noah for his misbehavior in front of the whole team again, okay? And after that, you should take your decision after evaluating the attitude of Omar. If he just refused or rejected the complaint, or if he just apologized and he returned the same misbehavior again, then you should here be tough. You should here use just like a managing techniques, but 50% of a manager. You again completed and you again did that again, so you have to make a firm decision. However, if he just apologized or it was not his mistake or he didn't actually want to harm her, then it's fine. According to the attitude, you should take your decision. Okay? Okay. Thank you so much, and I wish all to see you great leaders. And please don't forget to be the change you wish to see in the world. Lead by example. Thank you.